Hi, this is proton-proton cycle of fusion reaction. So these reactions happen in sun because of which very large amount of energy is produced, and in these process hydrogen is eventually converted into helium. Okay, so in the first step we have two hydrogen particles, hydrogen nuclei. These two will combine to form deuterium. Okay, then positron, then neutrino will be formed, and 0.42 mega electron volt energy will be released. Okay, then these two, this one, positron and electron will combine to form a gamma radiation, and 1.02 mega electron volt energy is released. Then this deuterium nuclei will combine again with one of hydrogen nuclei to form helium 3. This one helium of atomic number 2, atomic mass number 3 is also known as helium 3. So when deuterium and hydrogen will combine, they will form a helium 3 nuclei. Again, gamma radiation will be there, and 5.49 mega electron volt energy will be released. In the next step, this helium 3 nuclei will again combine with one more helium nuclei. So till now, from the first step to the third step, from here to here, only one helium 3 nuclei has been formed. So these whole steps must be repeated into two or twice, such that two helium 3 nuclei is formed. Okay, after that, these two helium 3 nuclei will combine to form helium nuclei plus one hydrogen nuclei, and 12.86 mega electron volt energy is released. Okay. So when you will add all these reactions, the final reaction will come as this one. Okay, 4 hydrogen nuclei plus 2 electron will combine to form a helium nuclei plus 2 neutrino and 6 gamma radiation plus 26.7 mega electron volt energy will be released. Okay, so thus 4 hydrogen atoms combine to form a helium nuclei, and it releases 26.7 mega electron volt of energy. So this is your proton-proton cycle, which happens in sun. Okay, now when the temperature, okay, one more thing, see, initially in our sun, when the temperature is less, these hydrogen cycle or proton-proton cycle is being formed. So as the hydrogen nuclei gets consumed, the only remaining will be helium. Okay, now after that, when only helium nuclei are there, so you can say that in that case, hydrogen in the core of the star will get depleted and it becomes helium, and after that the whole star will start getting cold. Because of that, all these helium particles will come towards each other or towards the center of the star. Okay, and then when they are again coming back, they are going to be very close to each other, because of which again temperature becomes very high. It reaches above 10 raised to power 8 Kelvin. After that, carbon-carbon cycle takes place in sun or a star, and the temperature of the star becomes very, very large than the temperature of sun. So it is also estimated that age of sun, our sun, is 5 into 10 raised to power 9 years. After this time, the burning of hydrogen will stop inside the sun, and sun will start to cool and will collapse under gravity. This will again raise the core temperature of sun, and then the outer envelope. Okay? The outer envelope of sun will keep on start expanding, and it may even engulf the earth, destroying the planet earth. So that will take a huge amount of time. That is 5 into 10 raised to power 9 years. Okay? Thank you.